That is so cool. Like, how quickly these colors are changing.
Today, we're learning about anodizing.
This is Jenifer Martinez, owner of SteamPunk Garage, a store that sells jewelry using anodized titanium.
Chemistry is very cool, especially when you see things that you just don't understand. And with anodizing, it definitely has that magical feel. It always makes me think of that scene from the old Total Recall movie when she's taking her fingernails and she's changing the color just by touching it. And it feels like that. You're just like, that is magic right there. Like, you are just touching it and the color is changing in a moment's notice. And there's something about that. It is so visually intriguing. And everyone has seen metal that has rainbow colors on it, and they just, it's never occurred to them like how that happens or why that happens. So titanium's a naturally reactive element, so you can color it by running electricity over the surface. This machine is called an anodizer, and what it does, it's essentially just running an electric current from one side of the alligator clips to the other side of the alligator clips. As you change the voltage, what it does is creates different levels of color. So what I'm doing here is I'm actually changing the voltage every time I do a little dip.
So how does the voltage affect the color?
So when you run electricity across the surface, it creates a layer of oxide. And as you crank the voltage up, the layer of oxide thickens and thickens. As it thickens, it refracts a different wavelength of light. So you see different colors. There's no pigment or dye. It's just reflecting light. The color builds upon itself, so it's always going to change color in the same order. So you basically start with like the low browns, and then it goes to like an eggplant, and then like a dark blue, and then an ice blue, and then it will go to kind of a yellow color, and then get golden, and then get pink, and then pink goes to purple, purple goes to purple, purple goes to teal, and then teal goes to green.
So in this clip, what are these three kind of liquids that you are dipping into, and what purpose does it serve?
So the first chemical is an acid etch here. And the acid etch, it's a chemical etch that's basically stripping off the natural layer of oxide that lives on titanium when it's just exposed to the air. So after we do that, then we rinse it. And the rinse is just distilled water, because what we don't want to do is mix the acid and the anodizing bath together, because it neutralizes the agents. And then we move on to the anodizing bath. And the anodizing bath is just baking soda and water, so it's relatively harmless. It's like an electrolyte solution, conducting the electricity more quickly through the water. You can do it without the baking soda, but you're only going to get like the low voltage colors, like the blues and the browns. So if you want to get the bright vivid colors or any rainbows, you need the reaction to happen more quickly. So there's definitely like a finesse move where when you're pulling it out, you have to pull it out quicker if you don't want it to happen so quickly at the bottom. But that's what creates the rainbow effect and why it doesn't all shift at once.
So what is this final solution that you're dipping?
So since I'm anodizing in a baking soda solution, basically if it dries, there will be baking soda everywhere and it will be a big powdered mess. So what I do is I just dip it in another solution of distilled water to rinse the baking soda off, and then I tend to Windex them and dry them just to make sure that that's not there, because nobody wants weird white powder coming on their jewelry.
If you want to check out more of Jenifer's jewelry and designs, visit her storefront on Etsy.